I have been saying in many videos now, the core statement that will be most effective is, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So I have been saying that and saying it and saying it, and every time I realize I'm not saying it, I say, am I practicing? I realize, oh no, I'm not practicing. Right back to it. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now Jesus swears by this statement, this affirmation. He says, do everything you can to keep saying this continuously. Whatever you do, you know, say this. This is all important to say this. Keep reminding yourself, I am free, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. So this is what I've been doing. And breakthroughs have been coming. Breakthroughs have been coming. This morning, a monumental breakthrough took place. So I'll keep on saying it. I really believe that it is like a miraculous affirmation that we don't really understand how it works, except somehow it seeps into us. And this, I got the sense that I am free this morning. I said, I am not sick, I am free. I am not tired, I am free. I am not sad, I am free. I am not lonely, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. I am not limited, I am free. I realized that the solution to all my problems is the exact, just one exact, I am free. That's it. That is the solution to all our troubles. I saw this. This is the solution. I said, wow. I can either choose to be sick or I can choose to be free. I can either choose to be tired or I can choose to be free. So I said, I'm not tired. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. See, I'm not sick. I am free. I am still a spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not needy. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not anxious, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not anxious, I am free. I am not desperate, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. So what I'm saying is, you choose either one or the other. Because the answer is always the same, and that is, I am free. The solution, the cure, is always the same. And I've eventually, in doing this practice today, I got to the point where I realized, I am not the cure, I am free. I am not the cure, I am free. And even I am not freedom, I am free. Okay, so it's possible to play with this affirmation and just try to, all day long I was trying to think of, you know, what to say. I am not a cure, I am free. That was one that's most powerful. I am not a cure, I am free. Freedom isn't a cure for something. Right? It is free. It is free. I am free. I am not some cure looking, this is what I am. I have to cure something. This is what my identity is. No, I am free. I'm not even a cure. I'm not even a cure. I am free. So I'm either choosing my identity as sickness, or I am choosing my identity as I am free. But I'm not choosing identity of I am free as a cure. I got to cure sickness. No. I either choose sickness or freedom. I either choose sickness or I am free. I either choose I am tired or I am free. I choose even I am sick or I am free. I choose either I am old or I am free. I choose either I am desperate or I am free. Why don't you? And so I was able to, I'm getting glimpses now into reality, freedom. I am freeness. I am free. Just simply, I am free. I'm getting these various glimpses, and then I'm seeing, wow, these affirmations really do work. And it's just that we seem like we're blind while we're doing them. It seems like very feeble. because we can't really feel like I am not sick, I am free, and yet I still feel sick. And you think, that's not doing anything, but it is, it is. We're getting to the point where we realize it's all just a choice. It's all just a choice. There's no cure for a choice. If we're choosing to be sick, that's, we're just choosing to be sick. But that's not our true identity. Our true identity is free. I am free. I am free. I'm not bound at all. I'm not bound. I am free. I am not bound. I am free. So Jesus makes a huge deal about this term free. I am free. I am not a body. I am free. I am not a body. I am free. I am not a doer. I am free. I am not a thinker. I am free. I could say I am not a sicker. You know, I am free. I am not a doubter. I am free. I am not an ager. I am free. I am not a confuser. I am free. I am not a conceptualizer. I am free. So as much as possible, I'm trying to say this all day long. Just keep going, just keep going back to it. And every day I'm getting a little better at this. So will it have an effect? I believe it will. I believe it will. But it takes a lot of faith because, again, we're not experiencing immediate results. I am not a fatiguer. I am free. So actually, all how we feel, everything is in the mind. Fatigue, sickness, all this is, we're imagining all this actually. The body isn't doing any of it. I am not weak. I am free. I am not limited. 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 I am free. I felt the wow. I'm feeling the wow from this one. That's why I stopped. I am not limited. I am free. I am not limited. I am free. This seems to have a very powerful reverberation to it. That, and I am not a cure. I am free. I am not a cure. I am free. I didn't come to this world to cure anything. I came to just express I am free and let others know they can choose the identity. I am free. That is what we already are. I am free. I am free doesn't need to cure anything. How can I am free need to cure? How could perfect freedom need to cure anything? It's not a cure for something. So, we don't need to cure sickness. We just need to accept that I am free. And see, this is the gap. We think we need to cure something. So we say, well, wait a minute, I was sick and now I'm free. But how did I get rid of the sickness? By choosing to be free, that's how. Choosing to accept our true nature, which I am free. So there isn't any cure for sickness or tiredness or anything. But we can choose our true nature. I am free. And in that freedom, there isn't any of the sickness or troubles like that. There isn't any. It's not that freedom is holding it back or curing it. Are dealing with it. No, it's not. It's not. It's not there at all. It's not there at all. This is the tricky part of the path, but we're navigating this. See, This is why saying the affirmations, and it helps navigate this tricky part. I am not a body, I am free. I am free. Repeat this as much as possible. I am free. I am not sick. I am free. I am not tired. I am free. I am not suffering. I am free. I am not suffering. I am free. So what we're doing is we're shifting identity from what we believe we are to what we really are. Transitioning to normality. So it's a matter of what do we think we are? Do we think that we're sick, or do we think that we are free? Freedom isn't freedom from something. See, freedom is not freedom from anything. It is simply freedom, free. It's not attached to anything. It's not freedom from. So we keep thinking, well, how do we get freedom from? There is no such thing as freedom from something. There's either, say, I am not a thing, I am free. I am not bound, I am free. So there's this conceptual gap, sort of, right, where it just... And this is what we have to keep working on through practicing, this relentless practice, instead of just spinning our wheels. I am not infirm, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. I am not limited, I am free. I am not in doubt. I am free. I am not awkward. I am free. I am not uncertain. I am free. I am not anxious. I am free. Now, it may seem that we're just saying words, but we don't hesitate to use the words, even though you may not be into it or feeling so much. That's okay. Keep saying the words, and gradually we'll start, you know, it'll sink in and sink in and sink in. Because when we're busy during the day, we may not always say, feel anything. It may seem kind of stale. I am not sick. I am free. I am not sick. I am free. I am not tired. I am free. I am not tired. I am not pain. I am free. I am not pain, I am free. I am not pain, I am free. So, I was using this today all day, and had good reason to use it. Had to carry a massive amount of heavy wood to like mules. And I was getting so tired in my shoulder and back were about collapsing, and I said, I am not tired, I am free. I am not tired, I am not free. I am not pain, I am not free. I am not weak, I am free. I am not weak, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. So I kept saying that as I'm being used like a mule, carry super heavy loads. I am not troubled. I am free. I am not a body. I am free. I am not a body. I am free. And it kept my spirits going very, very well. So there's an example of I am not bored. I am free. I am not conflicted. I am free. I am not conflicted. I am free. I am not conflicted. I am free. So Jesus says that the cumulative of repeating, constantly going back to this sinks in, and it wears away the resistance, and it enables this kind of leap of faith that take place. Other teachers have said similarly that the repetition of very powerful affirmation, mantra, saying, prayer, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not pain, I am free. I am not pain, I am free. I am not limitation, I am free. I am not a cure, I am not a cure, I am free. I am not a cure, I am free. I am not a thing, I am free. I am not an object, I am free. I am not tired, I am free. I am not weak, I am free. I am not, what did you say? I am not uncertain, I am free. I am not willless, I am free. I am not willless, I am free. I am not dejected, I am free. I am not defeated, I am free. I am not pathetic, I am free. I am not foolish, I am free. I am not lost, 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 I am free. So, as much as possible, keep repeating this, keep repeating this, keep, I am not a, even if you forget most, I am not a body, I am free, I am not a body, I am free, or if you even forget that, just say, I am free, 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 I am free. This is like the knockout punch for delusion, and we better land a knockout punch now, actually. It's the final round and we need to land a knockout. This is the knockout punch. I am not defeated, I am free. I am not defeated, I am free. I am not contested, I am free. I am not a contestant, I am free. I am not having trials, I am free. I am not having tribulations, I am free. I am not suffering. I am not suffering. I am free. I am not suffering. I am free. I am not suffering. I am free. Freedom can't suffer. I am not suffering. I am free. I am not dull, I am free. I am not apathetic, I am free. I am not hopeless, I am free. I am not hopeless, I am free. Freedom is what I am. I am not hopeless, I am free. And even freedom, like as a concept, is something, I'm not even freedom. I am free. I'm even free of freedom. Free is not a concept. It's not a concept where you can say, like, this is freedom. This is freedom. No, I am free. I am not bound. I am free. I am not limited. I am free. I am not limited. I am free. And so as we say this, we may be skeptical. We think, I'm not sure how is this going to work. What I'm finding is I'm having significant breakthroughs daily. I am not destitute, I am free. I am not indebted, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. I am not lacking, I am free. I am not lacking, I am free. I am not lacking, I am free. Free. I am not problematical, I am free. I am not a problem, I am free. I am not a problem, I am free. I am not a problem, I am free. I am not problematical, I am free. Jesus has explained how it manages to manifest in our life, but we're beyond the point of talking. We need to land the knockout punch at this time. I've already gone over all that many, many times in many different ways. We need to land the knockout punch, so not worry about that. I am not a problem. I am free. I am not problematical. I am free. I am not troubled. I am free. I am not trouble. I am free. I am not defined. I am free. I am not defined. I am free. I am not a life. I am free. I am not a person. I am free. I am not a human being. I am free. I am not a form. I am free. I am not a process. I am free. I am not anywhere. I am free. I'm not any when. I am free. I am not special. I am free. I am not special. I am free. Now, is it possible that in saying this, you might feel like a little exhausted or something? It's possible. It's a strain. I am not exhausted. I am free. I am not strained. I am free. I am not weary. I am free. I am not exhausted. I am free. I am not conflicted. I am free. I am not depressed. I am free. I am not tired. I am free. So the goal is to actually shift and experience freedom. Then the other stuff is simply not there anymore. Vanished without a trace. I am not run down, I am free. I am not exhausted, I am free. I am not tired, I am free. I am not pain, I am free. I am not suffering, I am free. I am not answering, I am free. I am not questioning. I am free. I am not symbolizing. I am free. I am not slipping. I am free. I am not falling. I am free. I am not failing. I am free. I am not failing. I am free. I am not failing. I am not failing. I am free. I am not failure. I am free. I am not failure. I am free. I am not fear. I am free. I am not fear. I am free. I am not fear. I am free. am not failure, I am free. I am not fear, I am free. I am not vulnerable, I am free. I am not feeble, I am free. I am not feeble, I am free. I am not feeble, I am free. This is really, when we deny that we're free, then we're asserting that we're feeble, that we're fearful, that we're fatigued. I am not death, I am free. I am not death, I am free. I am not feeble, I am free. I am not fantasy, I am free. I am not fantasy, I am free. So, I am not a body, I am free. 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 I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit as exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So, just keep driving this truth home. And don't worry about, well, did the Holy Spirit hear me? Did something hear me? Just keep doing it. Don't be looking for results. Spend more practicing if you're. And so, watch your mind. And when you catch yourself and you're not practicing, you suddenly say, "Oh, I'm not practicing." Right back to practicing. I am not a body. I am free. I am not fear. I am free. I am not failure. I am free. I am not feeble. I am free. I am not suffering, I am free. I am not sunken, I am free. I am not defeated, I am free. I am not impoverished, I am free. I am not searching, I am free. I am not needy, I am free. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Basically, we're just reminding ourselves of what we are. So what we are is already true, already present. That's why we're going to succeed. We will succeed. It's not like we're trying to create this or give birth to it or something through affirmation. No, it's already there. So all we have to do is accept it's already there. I am not doubt, I am free. I'm not unawareness, I am free. I am free, I am free, I am free, I am free, I am free. So just keep working on it, just keep landing that knockout punch, and this is what I'm doing. As soon as we start thinking about something else, well, I wonder how this one's going to... Oops, I'm not practicing. I am not a body. I am free. So, oops, I'm not practicing. You can catch it. And I caught it today hundreds of times. Oh, when the mind drifts off and starts drifting off and, you know, thinking, well, how is this... Oh, this is great. I wonder how I'm going to feel when I'm better. Whoops, I'm not practicing. Mind's very tricky. It is amazing how tricky the mind is. And it just sort of wanders up, and this is a good way to spin it. I said, oh, not practicing. I am not a body. I am free. I am not fear. I am free. I am not trouble. I am free. I'm not in uncertainty. I am free. I am not isolated. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. I believe that the teachers have told us truly. They say if you say this prayer affirmation mantra over and over and over, this is the fast way you will succeed. The trouble is who does that? Who has the faith to do that? That's the trouble. Sure, it's easy, but who does it? Almost no one, because they start looking for results. The mind says, "No, wait a minute, how many times do I need to say this, and what, I'm not quite seeing the result, and I wonder, oh yeah, this, if, what this one, if this works, how am I, what kind of life am I going to have?" And before you know it, you've dropped it, dropped the practice. And of course, in our practice to help us to pass this tricky gap, we say, I know that I've already successfully succeeded. I've already successfully succeeded at this. So I'm not saying, how is this going to work? I know I already successfully succeeded at this. Then it's like, wow, I did it. See, it gives you this feeling like you already did it, and this brings tremendous build motivation to you, and it makes it much easier to practice when you feel this is something you've already succeeded. You squeeze time out of it. Don't give time any place to get a hold of you. So I know, I am not fearful. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. I've already successfully succeeded at this. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. I am not fearful. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. So the key is to drill certain real simple affirmations into your psyche so much so that you can just go to them. It's like just walking or something. It's easy, but you have to stick with it to the point where you've got it. It's like a song, learning a song. You've played it so many times, in the midst of anything, someone can say, "Oh, play that song," and you don't even have to think about it. You just can play it. Yeah, but that takes a lot of repetition. And so, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Let that be the number one go-to. And I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. I know I already successfully know. And then, that I'm already successfully free. I know I already successfully know that I'm already successfully free. I'm already successful at this. I know. You can use that. That's a little more complicated. And then the other one is, I am not a body. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. I am not fearful. I am free. I am not troubled. I am free. I am not distraught. I am free. I am not despairing. I am free. I am not depressed. I am free. I am not endangered, I am free. I am not misunderstood, I am free. I am not uncertain, I am free. I am not uncertain, I am free. I am not rejected, I am free. I am not excluded, I am free. I am not excluded, I am free. I am not excluded, I am free. I am not endangered, I am free. I am not bothered, I am free. I am not bothered, I am free. I am not troubled, I am free. I am not terrified, I am free. I am not terrified, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. That's a powerful one, I hadn't got to that one yet. I am not traumatized, I am free. This one's really potent there. I am not traumatized. I am free. I am not. You have to do a whole separate video on this one. This is really. This gets down to the nitty gritty. I am not traumatized. I am free. This one. Yeah. Wow. So we can either choose to be traumatized or choose to be free. One of the two. I am not traumatized. I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. So this one hits so hard, it's a wow. This is a full stop in the wow here. This one hit home real strong. So I'm just riding out the earthquake here. So again, super important, you expect in any time you practice, you're going to hit the hot button. To hit the button is like, wow, so the wow is, you're going to reach that wow somehow. You know when you really put yourself into it, and so I've got to really, really, really succeed. You're going to find it, and then that's when you got to manage. Too afraid, you know what to do. What I say do is full stop in the wow. It's a tidal change. It's a earthquake in an earthquake, It's a transformation, landscape shift, stunning, shocking. I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. This one is very, very close to home here, wow. So when you get to this type of situation, you're careful, you're patient. So okay, just give a little time to get used to this here. Let's not try to, and don't spin off somewhere detached. Just stay present with it. This is really, I am not shaken up. I am free. I am not traumatized. I am free. So, it seems that this basic traumatized is very important. I had a dream, had several dreams that are so definitely intended to try to traumatize me severely. That Urgench massacre, Genghis Khan Urgench massacre dream was designed to completely traumatize me, but it didn't. Which is why I'm able to give these exercises out now. Otherwise, I wouldn't have gotten this far, you see? So there was really an attempt by the mind, the psyche, the one mind to traumatize me and to prevent this from coming out. I am not traumatized. I am free. Genghis Khan asks us, what do you think of the massacre? I say, well, I think I am not traumatized. I am free. I am not traumatized. I am free, General Khan. I am not traumatized. I am free. I am not traumatized. I am free. There was another one, a dream where there's this building, this dark building, and there was this woman's voice screaming and moaning in misery and terror, like she's being like incredibly traumatized to the most. And went on and on and on, and eventually I said, you know, this is all staged. This is attempting to traumatize you. This is an actual actress attempting to traumatize me, thinking that some hideous trauma is being subjected to hideous trauma. Just, you know, just the voice and the feebleness and the trauma. You just, you know, it was like, oh gosh. But in the dream, I said, hey, wait a minute. This is a setup. I'm being set up. This is something is trying to traumatize me, and thereby prevent me from, you know, continuing along the path. So there really are these defenses that arise that are quite surprising. I had a dream last night that it was so bizarre. I can't even explain it. All I can say was like some ancient time in like the Africa, and there was this I was there, and there's this sort of a youngish woman, dark, very dark skin, dark hair, dark skin, and somehow I wanted to have my back, do something on my back, and she did something meticulous on my back. I don't know, it was a painting or tattooing or something. And then I wandered about this way in all these bizarre experiences. I mean, and it's just, It was something you can't even. How did I dream that up? I can't even imagine how I dreamed it up, but it was something very traumatic in some way. It was something that was designed to get me somehow maybe identified with my body or something like that. Some sort of she did something to the body, the back. I couldn't see what she had done. It was in my back. Very odd, very bizarre. So I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. So we get, I think as we go along, we get these backlashes in the collective consciousness that tries to stop you from being free, from choosing freedom. I am free. It was some sort of dream that was designed to get me identifying with the body instead of spirit, you know, and to pull me into trauma somehow, overall trauma. And then there was some dream that somehow morphed into the church and the communion wafer and the different types they were using. But it was all in this cinemascope, grand, massive, epic kind of dream that was just overwhelming almost in the epic scope and the weirdness of it. And you know, so maybe it has to do with how we try to get ourselves to identify. Maybe, you know, like tattooing and self-mutilation, all these kinds of things that are done. I know Africa, they do a lot of stuff of raising bumps on your skin and lots of ways of, you know, decorating the body. And there was some super intricate thing that was done to me. Super intricate. Almost like, you know, I almost felt like it was like etching a chip, a memory chip on my back or something like that, meticulous, you know. It was like somehow putting like using the skin in like a microchip, you know, putting all the little tiny electrical channels or whatever they call them, etching that into my back, etching something super intricate in my back, which then made me feel a certain way and changed, you know, how I felt or something. So I am not trauma. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not traumatized. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. So this is something, these dreams that come up are something that are like, wow, I'm not expecting that, this. How could you expect anything like that? So the path is a little more difficult than, you know, it's not all just a bowl of cherries and you just roll right through it. No, it seems as though there are, you know, it's a struggle. There are a backlash, an attempt to keep you traumatized. Yeah, I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. So this one feels like it's got a lot of fruit to it. So this full stop and the wow is very important, that you don't try to spin it or think it too much, because I can feel this is just enormous. And just okay, full stop and the wow. This is the very all-important discipline. You just stay present with what is you're feeling right now. Don't try to spin it in any way. Don't try to make it more or less or do anything. You're just hanging out with it. Hanging loosely with it, just hanging out. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not sickness. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. See, trauma often has to do with seeing someone else, something horrible, like that Urgench massacre was just a virtually infinite amount of mutilated corpses, and everyone was different. It was designed to traumatize. See, I wasn't hurt, but it was designed to traumatize me. So I said, I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. So we may need to go over this one some more. So don't worry. Just get used to entering into this right now. I am not trauma, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not threatened, I am free. I am not threatened, I am free. You may have people trying to threaten you or threatening to traumatize you or, you know, bring about trauma. Maybe not on you, but on something else that would draw. And so they're trying to scare you, keep you from practicing this. But if you just practice this, I am not trauma, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. And we can say, too late, General Khan. I've already successfully succeeded in this. It's too late. Vanished. The transition has already vanished. I am not traumatized. I am free. See, once we get to here, you can feel the path, the spiritual path, and the intensity of it. No question about it. It's you realize then there is this, you know, tremendous resistance, and yet the freedom is calling us. I am not traumatized. I am free. So, I've already successfully succeeded at this. I already successfully succeeded at this. Done deal. It's already finished. Already done. So, I am not traumatized. I am free. I am not traumatized. I am free. And so you try to feel like it's already the case. It's already true. You're already feeling it. Already feeling, I am free. I would say this is probably the most raw, powerful practicing I've ever gotten into. This just hits home. This is a pivotal issue here. Free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Now you should know that what they show in movies and televisions and pictures and every place they possibly can are really pictures of trauma. They have pop-up advertisements, for instance, on YouTube. And I'm noticing more and more, there's some like gigantic, hideous dinosaur with the super long. They try to make them look as menacing and as traumatic to you as possible. And they're, you know, ready to devour or something. This is attempt to traumatize you. This is attempt to traumatize you. And that's why I stay away from all that stuff as much as possible. From the news stories are designed to traumatize you. There's no question about this. We are trying to keep traumatizing ourselves so that we don't realize that we are free. I would say the stock and trade of this planet is to traumatize. It severely impairs our reason. It impairs our reason so bad we don't even realize that we're free. That's our identity. So I am not trauma. I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. Stay away from video games, stay away from movies, stay away from marketing, advertising, stay away from television, stay away from commercials, stay away from magazines, comics, books, you know, stay away from all that stuff designed to traumatize. And instead say, I am not trauma, I am free. I am not traumatized, I am free. I am not trauma, I am free. So I don't know what's going to happen with this one. This is just, feels like when, you know, hit the nerve when we get our teeth drilled. Wow, you hit the nerve. You know you hit the nerve. This is hitting a nerve. Just continues to reverberate, to reverberate, to reverberate, to reverberate. Wow. Wow. I was carrying such heavy loads today that my ankles felt they were ready to break down. My feet, my ankles. It's just like, it's just worn out. It was pretty cool though, to do that. But really, this one shoulder, it was just like broken down. My back, I could feel it was breaking down. Had to go to the other shoulder. It's just like, good Lord. That's the kind of stuff for young people. That was a trauma in itself. So I am not trauma, I am free. I am not trauma, I am free. Now, we may not understand, but I swear that this is effective to say this. I am not trauma. I am free. Keep stating that in the face of the sphere of trauma. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. Now, this, of course, this is shaking things up. We're down to the shake up place here. This is the bare knuckles have come out now. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. Okay. Wow. Well, this could go on for hours. I'm telling you, this is getting late, and so don't worry. We will not stop here. We will. I am not trauma. I am free. We're not running away from this. We're not trying to escape it. No way. We're facing it straight on. We're facing General Genghis Khan straight on, saying, General, I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. So this, by far and away, is the most... I can feel the most reaction of anything, any practice I've ever done. This is the most volatile. I am not volatile, I am free. I am not volatile, I am free. I am not volatile, I am free. But this is what practice is all about, right? I mean, we want success. So the practice is all about success. And so, I am not volatile. I am free. I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. And just saying that helps settle you down. I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. I know I already successfully know that I've already successfully succeeded at this. I am not volatile. I am free. I am not trauma. I am free. This is absolutely the hardest hitting practice ever. Full stop in the wow. This has hit just an incredibly deep nerve, metaphorically speaking. Like bedrock. I'm not trauma, I am free. I am not not trauma. I am free. Wow. Well, takes a lot of guts to go forward now. You know, what else can I do? Gonna have to go to sleep on this one. Good Lord, I don't know what's next. but I'll survive it. I am not survival, I am free. I am not survival, I am free. There's another one. I am not survival, I am free. Wow. That's it, even harder if it's possible. I am not survival, I am free. This is where sitting quietly in a place that you're used to is very helpful. In therapy, you have a therapist there to help you with that. Something like this. But in this case, I think it might be the therapist that has the trouble. You need many to help them. I am not survival. I am free. Says, okay, therapist, just sit quietly. Don't move. Don't get up. Don't do anything. Just sit quietly. Full stop in the wow. Just don't struggle with the struggle. Just let the wow be there. Just relax and say, wow, this is great. This is wonderful. I love therapy. I love being a therapist. Being a therapist is wonderful. Just breathe. This is a lot of fun. This is enjoyable. I like doing this. Nothing I need to do. Nothing I need to say. Just sit here. Enjoy the wow. Have a wow party. Just enjoy the wow. Well earned. Very well earned. See, I helped the therapist out. Just like that, the therapist is now, great, everything's fine. The therapy is working. Hallelujah. Time well spent. Great job, time well spent. Wonderful. Wonderful wow here. This one feels like huge blocks, like jagged blocks are just all being falling apart or moving or something. I just, you know, it's more blocky and jagged and large than anything. And so I just wow, it's great. Just hang out with that. Very epical. That's a word. Maybe just epic. Very epic. Don't let yourself get tired or sleepy or anything like that. There were some barnyard animals recently. I went over to this fence, and there was a fence, and then there was like a double fence that went up about 3 feet to keep the pigs, anyone from touching the pigs or something. Their pigs from biting. I don't know what the pigs do, but you couldn't get through. There's chicken wire fencing and chicken. So about 3 feet up, you couldn't get through. And then after that, there was just a single fence that was pretty spacious. So I said, "Oh, pig, hello, how are you?" But I couldn't touch the pig or anything, no. There's chickens in the barnyard, and the chickens are looking at me, and I'm up saying, hi, chick. And the chicken said, "Hey, maybe they got some food for me, or, you know, something. I'm going to check them out." So what did the chicken do? Was the chicken stupid? It said, "Oh, there's chicken wire. There's nothing I could do." Chicken says, light went off in the chicken's head, and the chicken says, "Hey, pig is here, I'm here, he's there, what do I need to do here?" And the chicken said, "Hey," and it like jumped up, jumped right on the pig's back. And now it had access to me, you see. Suddenly it gained enough height to go beyond the double fencing. And then the other chicken's looking at it and said, "Huh. That's a pretty good idea." And so another chicken jumped up, so he got this pig with two chickens on its back. What can the pig do, you know? What can a pig do? It can't reach around and knock him off or anything. It can just walk, try to walk. And the chickens, it's pretty funny. Chickens are not stupid. Chickens are not stupid at all, actually. I like chickens. They're very skillful what they do, actually. It's pretty amazing. And of course, what better friend do we have than the ones that lay eggs every day? The chickens, are friends, actually. They've been with us domesticated for a long time. So this chicken wanted to say hello. I'm going to jump up on the pig's back. I'm not going to let that stop pig stop me. Anything stop me. Actually, the pig helped me. Thank you, pig. So in this one, the rawness is there. I just have to go with it, you know. Wow. All right. Very great. We will see what is next. That's it for this one.